Welcome students, in this video we are going to discuss the lesson Reading Works of Art by Abha Bhagwat. Abha Bhagwat. Bhagwat teaches art at Aksharnandan School in Pune. Graduated from Abhinav Mahavidyalaya. In 2004, she did Masters in Painting from Academy of Arts University, San Francisco. Reading Works of Art. Syed Haider Raza. Syed Haider Raza, popularly known as Raza, was a renowned Indian artist. Simple geometric shapes, striking color combinations, captivating compositions. These are some of the characteristic features of his paintings, and so are the colors blue and orange. You will find them in almost all his paintings. None of his paintings depict lifelike human figures or copies of scenes from his environment. His paintings belong to the abstract style of paintings. Such paintings are not inspired by any external factor. They originate when the artist tries to peep into his own inner mind. They are made by arranging circles, triangles, squares, rectangles, lines, dots in different compositions using effective techniques of applying paint, attractive color combinations, achieving balance in some places and creating imbalance in other places. Raza found his paintings through his study of Indian art and its heritage, cultural context, and philosophy. His pictures seem to radiate peace and life at the same time. We realize that the painting is a visible form of very deep thought. Very few abstract paintings communicate with the viewers as much as Raza's do. This lesson is divided into two parts. The first part is about Syed Haider Raza, a famous artist who is popularly known as Raza. Raza's paintings are of abstract style. None of his paintings are related to human figures or copies of scenes from his environment. Abstract style of painting is not inspired by any external factor. Rather, it comes from inside our mind. Abstract style reflects an artist's inner mind and his emotions. Raza's paintings mostly consist of simple geometric shapes, striking color combinations, and captivating compositions. His paintings are made by arranging circles, triangles, squares, rectangles, lines, dots in different compositions. Most of Raza's paintings are dominated by the colors blue and orange. Raza discovered his paintings through his study of Indian art and its heritage, cultural context, and philosophy. His paintings are very lively, and yet they also radiate peace at the same time. Viewers are able to connect with Raza's paintings. Even though very few abstract paintings are able to communicate with viewers, Raza's paintings are able to create that connection with the weavers. Raza was born in a small village in Madhya Pradesh. He began to paint from the age of 12. He studied art at the Chitrakala Mahavidyalaya at Nagpur and then at the JJ School of Art in Mumbai. Later, he went to France to study art. After a few years, he decided to settle in France. His wife was French. He won many national and international awards. He was honored with all the three Padma Awards, Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. With all the awards and honors, his paintings were exploring of spiritual, metaphysical path. Gradually, the bindu or point came to be the core of his paintings. He described his work in these words: "My work is my own inner experience and involvement with the mysteries of nature and form, which is expressed in color, line, space, and light." Sometimes an artist's thoughts appear to be too complex or even complicated when they are expressed through words. For him, the effective medium of communication is his work, his paintings. Raza had great creativity. His paintings are very expressive. This great artist passed away on 23rd July 2016 at the age of 94. Leaving behind a legacy of sensitive paintings achieved through extraordinary compositions of lines and colors that depict extraordinary compositions. Raza was born in a small village in Madhya Pradesh. He began to paint from the age of 12. And from then, he discovered his love for painting and decided to pursue the art of painting. He studied art at the Chitrakala Mahavidyalaya at Nagpur and then at the JJ School of Art in Mumbai. Later, he went to France to study art. He then decided to settle in France and married a French woman. His paintings became so famous and were so meaningful that he won many national and international awards. He was honored with all the three Padma Awards, Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, and Padma Vibhushan. His paintings were exploring a spiritual and metaphysical path. His abstract style of painting helped him to discover his own inner self. And this led him to the path of success. Gradually, the bindu or point came to be the core of his paintings. He described his work in these words: "My work is my own inner experience and involvement with the mysteries of nature and form, which is expressed in color, line, space, and light." Many artists have difficulty in expressing their thoughts and emotions in words. They are able to express their thoughts in a better manner through their art. For Raza, the effective medium of communication was his work, his paintings. He was able to communicate in a better way through his paintings. Raza was a very creative person. His paintings were very expressive. His paintings have a deep meaning to them. This great artist passed away on 23rd July 2016 at the age of 24. And he left behind a legacy of sensitive paintings that depict extraordinary compositions of lines and colors. Gond art. Gond art is a tribal art. It has been developed and preserved by the Gond tribal people residing largely in the Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, and Odisha states of India. From their traditional tales and mythology, we learn that they have lived in India for thousands of years even before the other inhabitants came here. The Gondi language is similar to Telugu, a Dravidian language. The second part of the lesson is Gond art. Gond art is a tribal art. The Gonds are the largest Adivasi community in India. They are Dravidians whose origin can be traced to the pre-Aryan era. The Gond art has been developed and preserved by the Gond tribal people residing largely in the Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, and Odisha states of India. The word Gond comes from Kond, which means green mountains in the Dravidian idiom. The Gondi language is similar to Telugu, which is a Dravidian language. Gond art has spread mainly in central India. Originally, people used to draw pictures on the earthen walls of their houses. Most folk arts involve natural techniques of preparing colors and use of several mediums. They are transferred from generation to generation in a smoothly flowing process. Gond art is no exception to this. A house decorated with beautiful pictures creates a pleasant atmosphere. Also, art is a medium of recording and preserving what is seen. In folk arts, you yourself prepare the canvas, the surface on which to draw, and the colors with which you draw. That is why creating folk art is a very enriching experience. This richness is reflected in the choice of their medium. In the days of past, several things in nature, such as soils of different shades, the juice of plants, leaves, tree bark, flowers, fruits, and even things like coal and cow dung were used to prepare colors. The different colors, various textures, and patterns were used here. After year, lending a simplicity to the art. When we see these pictures, we realize that a picture drawn this way or the other can look equally beautiful. What a deep thought this art conveys, and so easily. In the Gond style of art, we see that the outlines may vary a little from artist to artist, but the designs that fill it make the whole picture look lively and attractive. The designs include simple textures achieved using dots, straight lines, dotted lines, curvy shapes and circles. Special attention is given to the choice of various colors so that the total effect is amazing and beautiful. In today's age of commercialization, many men have taken up Gond art. But the roots of folk arts probably lie in women's daily chores like cleaning and decorating the house, dealing with natural colors in the course of cooking and in their leisure time activities. Gond art has spread mainly in central India. Originally, people used to draw pictures on the earthen walls of their houses to decorate the walls and beautify their houses. Gond art is a type of folk art, and most folk arts involve natural techniques of preparing colors and use of several mediums. Art is a medium of recording and preserving what is seen. To preserve Gond art, it is transferred from generation to generation in a smoothly flowing process. Creating folk art is a very enriching experience because here you yourself prepare the canvas, the surface on which to draw, and the colors with which you draw. Earlier, different things that were available in nature were used to create different colors, such as the juice of plants, leaves, tree bark, flowers, fruits, and even things like coal and cow dung. The use of natural things gives a simplicity to the art. In Gond style of art, the outline of the art may differ from artist to artist, but the pattern or the design that is filled in the painting or the art makes it look more lively and attractive. The designs that are used to fill the art include simple textures achieved using dots, straight lines, dotted lines, curvy shapes, and circles. In today's age of commercialization, many men have taken up Gond art. But originally, Gond art was derived from women's daily chores like cleaning and decorating the house, dealing with natural colors in the course of cooking, and in their leisure time activities. Answer the following. Which style do Raja's paintings belong to? Raja's paintings belong to the abstract style. Second question. How are abstract type of paintings made? Abstract type of paintings are made by arranging circles, triangles, squares, rectangles, lines, and dots in different compositions using effective techniques of applying paint, attractive color combinations, achieving balance in some places, and creating imbalance in other places. Next question. Through what did Raja find his paintings? Raja found his paintings through his study of Indian art and its heritage, cultural context, and philosophy. Next, gradually, what came to be the core of his paintings? Gradually, the bindu or point came to be the core of his paintings. Next, who has developed and preserved the Gond art? Gond art has been developed and preserved by the Gond tribal people residing largely in the Indian states like Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, and Odisha. In the days of past, what was used to prepare colors? So earlier, several things in nature, such as soils of different shades, the juice of plants, leaves, tree bark, flowers, fruits, and even things like coal and cow dung were used to prepare colors. Next, what do the roots of corn art lie in? The roots of this folk art probably lie in a woman's daily chore of cleaning and decorating the house, dealing with natural colors in the course of cooking and in their leisure time activities. Do as directed. First, you will find them in almost all his paintings. Identify the verb and its tense. So here the verb is will find and its tense is simple future tense. Next, such paintings are not inspired by any external factor. Add a question tag. So the sentence will be, such paintings are not inspired by any external factor, are they? Next, he won many national and international awards. Make interrogative. Didn't he win many national and international awards? Next sentence. His paintings are very expressive. Change to present perfect tense. So the sentence will be, his paintings have been very expressive. Thank you, students. I hope you all enjoyed the video.